give me a kiss to build a dream on. In my imagination, we'll thrive upon that kiss. Oh, sweetheart, I ask no more than this. A kiss to build a dream on. Give me a kiss before you leave me. And my imagination will feed my hungry heart. Leave me one thing before we part. A kiss to build a dream on. When I'm alone with my fancies, I'll be with you, weaving romances, making believe they're true. Oh, give me your lips for just a moment, and my imagination will make that moment live. Give me what you alone can give, a kiss to build a dream on.
Since its founding, Arroyo has lived in peace, its canyons sheltering it from the outside world. It is home, your home. But the scars left by the war have not yet healed, and the earth has not forgotten.
I have never played a big brute guy that can use big guns. I have never used a missile launcher or a minigun or anything like that in these games. Fair enough, Axion. I don't want to. People are used to playing big, strong guys who are also dumb. And although my guy isn't going to be, say, intelligence 3 dumb, he might be intelligence 4. Or it might be average. For sure, I know for certain is that he is going to be very strong. We'll go with strength 9. And he's gonna be pretty tough. Perception, see, hear, taste, and notice things for a sharpshooter. He doesn't necessarily... average perception is fine. Okay, we're definitely going to bring that down. His agility doesn't need to be very high either. And his luck can be average. So with that, I think we'll up his perception by 1. And you know what would be really interesting? If he wasn't that bad of a talker either. That would be interesting. Yeah, no intelligence 1 playthrough, no. No. I kind of like this. He doesn't have very many action points, though. 7. That should be enough to fire a weapon. Alright. What do we have for thing? Bruiser. A little slower, but a little bigger. You may not hit as often, but when they feel it, you do. But my strength is increased. Nah. Whoa. I could almost do this. Action points. Oh, interesting. My action points don't make a difference between agility 4 and 5. No, then I won't be a bruiser. That won't make much sense. One-hander, no. Finesse, no. Heavy-handed. You attack harder, not better. Your attacks are very brutal, but lack finesse. You rarely cause a good critical, but you always do more melee damage. That could be interesting. Fast shot, bloody mess, of course. Jinxed, good-natured. Chem-resistant. Sex appeal. Ooh. Nah, we won't do a sex appeal guy. Although, it'd be really interesting, actually, now that I think about it. You know what? I could be a big hunky dude. I could be Hunkenheimer. Now that I think about it. That'd be interesting. That would explain why he would have, like, slightly better average charisma and he's this big guy. You know what? Sure. I like that, actually. I like that. Oh yeah, I already figured out what his name is going to be. Rayan. I know, not Ryan. It's like Ryan, but with an A in it. I don't know. I was looking up names because I saw, like, the generic one have kind of tribal names, but I don't want to be, like, Ugthump the Destroyer. But Rayan could be something that is be seen in, like, a tribal world and a kind of modern post-apocalyptic world. We can call him Ray for short. Okay. And actually, 25 is a good age. I am generic default dude. You come from a long line of generic default dudes. Do I want to be skilled or gifted? We did. He could also be gifted. Ugh Thump sounds like a great tribal name for a sex appeal character. Yeah, fair enough, but I don't like goofy names. I don't like goofy names. We're taking big guns, without a doubt. The operational and maintenance, oh god, it's 2x agility. Really? I want to be good at big guns, so maybe I should. Ooh, flamethrowers, that's interesting. AG. You know what? Maybe we're going to reverse this. Because, I mean, I want him to be good at big guns. That's the whole point, right? We can say he has a lower perception because he's used to looking at himself in the mirror. I could also be really boring and give him average perception and endurance, but no. We're going to do that. All right, what else is he going to be good at? That's his weapon skill, so we got that figured out. Speech, maybe. Barter, maybe. Gambling, maybe. Not repair, I did that before. Throwing could be interesting. Okay, big guns also consume AP like nobody's business. Okay. So high AG is almost a requirement for running big guns. Okay, then I feel really good about doing that. Thanks for the heads up on that, Axion. You know what? We are going to go with speech. If I'm going to go with the somewhat charismatic guy, we're going to go all the way. So big guns, speech, Hunkenheimer here. And should I just do unarmed? I didn't do unarmed before. I did melee weapons before. I wouldn't mind, since he's not an idiot. It'd be nice if he knew how to do something else. The finding and removal of traps, and the setting of explosives for demolition purposes. That could be interesting. Not science, not repair. I mean, speech and barter, of course, that kind of goes hand in hand, right? But no. Gambling, no. Maybe outdoorsman. Yeah, okay. Okay. Alright, we're gonna go with big gun, speech, and outdoorsman. Yeah. Okay. I think that'll do quite nicely. Where are my other options? Oh. Can I save him? Oh, yeah, okay. I could have done this beforehand. It's always good to do live stuff. Yeah, I was thinking traps too because of explosives. Because rocket launchers, you know, they use explosives. But you know what? We can always dump some points into that still. Very similar to like last playthrough, I put points into like first aid even though I didn't have that taught. So I think that's what we're going to focus on. Yeah, okay. I like that. Alright, let's say done. Oh, what's this style? Oh, I see. Long-haired dude. Oh, I can be long-haired. Oh, yeah. We're going to be long-haired dude. Oh, of course. Your long flowing locks bounce upon your shoulders as you jog on by. Your fellow villagers look in awe at the multifaceted strands of your glorious mane. Sparkle in the morning light. Race is nothing. I guess that's just for, I don't know, maybe some modded playthrough? I'm not too sure, but I'm really happy with this. Yeah, I'm happy with this. Done.
Come in, chosen one. There are things you must know. The village is dying. The signs are everywhere. Withering crops. Dying Brahmin. Sick children. There is hope, however. A slim hope. That few know of. The old discs speak of an item called called the Garden of Eden Creation Kit. It is said it can bring life to the wasteland. This will be your quest, if you prove yourself worthy. For that proof, you must first journey to the Temple of Trials. If you survive, come back to me. We will talk more. Our life is in your hands, Chosen One. Prove yourself. Find the G.E.C.K. Be our salvation.
I am Axion. In fact, to answer your question, the one and only mod I'm running is pretty much one of the one and only mods for Fallout 2, which is the Fallout 2 Restoration Project, version 2.3.3. That confirms its install. Who is this? This is Clint, a fellow tribesman. You see a young man with bulging muscles and a very confident air about him. Well, let's talk with him first, shall we? And of course, our shift key highlights stuff, which is great. Good day to you, Rayan. You have not completed the trial of the Elder and may not pass. Well, I have some questions for you. Forgive me, but I have no answers to your questions. Take the trial set before you by the Elder and prove yourself worthy to lead our people. Very well. So you know what the best thing about this game is? When I save it, there's more than 10 slots. There's a whole bunch of slots. There's an unlimited number of slots. Oh my god. If I save up to 217, we're in trouble. So I'm just going to save one spot that says start, in case I ever have to come back. And then I'm going to say... Actually, wait, no. No, no, no. Yes. I'm actually going to call this quick save. And then I'm going to save this one to start. Just in case. Sounds what sounds perfect for? Oh yeah, I know. I am a save scummer. This is a temple. You see nothing out of the ordinary. Okay, fair enough. Temple, fire pit. Oh, I miss there being detailed descriptions of stuff. Sometimes there is, sometimes there ain't. Bones. You think that these might be horned kangaroo bones, but you cannot be sure. They are too weathered to make a final determination. Rocks. Alright, well, let's go in. Alright, so let's check our inventory. We have a spear, a razor-tipped polearm. The shaft is wooden, and the tip is worked to steel. Ooh, worked steel. We know steel working. Look how great we are. Hello, Andropel, my friend. How the heck are you? I hope you're doing well. There are ants in my pants. Do I not get to look at them? Do I have to just try to talk with them? You see, giant ant. It looks unhurt. That's good. We see a incense burner. Well. Well, here comes the ant. Here comes the ant. Now, let's see what hitting him is going to be like. Because we also have a strong kick. AP4 versus a thrust or a throw. Interesting. Well, either way, we have to get closer to it. 46% versus... 56. Well, I'll take the 56, Chuck. Oh, nice. Long time off of work. That's really great. That's like steel working. All right. Giant Ant was hit for 9 points and was killed. All right. Is there anything in your body? It is dead. Yep. It sure is. It sure is. So I don't need this no lousy spear. I have my fists. Also, there we go. I was like, where is the ant? It should be here. Oh, that's excellent. That's right. Come right up next to me. That way I get two shots of kicking at you. Oh, and now you're dead. I would say, stupid bug, you go squish now, but my guy's a little bit more intelligent than that. Alright. Well, let's go to the right first. It's a wall. It's a torch. Can I take it? No. If by we know steel working you mean there's steel scraps scattered all around the wasteland and you crudely hammer into tools and weapons, then yes, you know, steel working. Alright, so I can either go up to it and try to smash it, or we can be smart, move back a couple times, and wait for him to come closer to me. Alright, I still need to do two, because I wouldn't mind kicking at him twice. So if I go back four, and of course do a little spin around, and say turn, let's see if he'll get closer to me. There we go. Oh, still one away. Okay, and if I move three, now I should be okay. That's right, I'm smart. Stupid hexapet. Yes, that's right. You go squish now. Boom! Beautiful. See? I'm so smart. This isn't my first Fallout game, everyone. Although I have never beat Fallout 2. Never, ever, 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 ever. I got to a point. Last time I played this game, I got to a point where I was just, I don't know, somewhere far east, and I was farming, like, all these weapons and stuff, and I'm like, eh. And then you know what happens. Another game shows up, and then you forget about this one, but not this time. Much similar to Fallout 1, I will be continuing this until I beat it. Hello, Ant. I'm not getting any closer to you. Ant. I will get one closer to you. Okay, I don't think it can see me coming. Oh, shit. I got too close to it. And now I got hit for 2 hit points. This it serves me well. Ugh. Ooh. I hit the crap out of him on that one. And, of course, there's a pot. With some healing power. It will bring the feeling of sleep to my head. Alright, anything else on the ground? Yeah, fair enough. But I'm not embarrassed to not a floor depression. Interesting. I'm not too impressed. If I get really, really, really stuck, I'll either ask for help or literally just look it up. Because not like I'm not going to immediately do that. But if I get to a point where I get frustrated or I think it's taking way too long and it's not entertaining to deal with, you better believe I will do that. Just because I wouldn't want to watch some guy try to figure something out for like 2 hours. That would just be not good times. Oh no, it's a teeny scorpion! I know. It's a very sad floor. You know what? I gotta bring up the speed of things in this game. Just a second. Preferences. Combat speed. Yeah. There we go. Speaking of things not taking too long, we're gonna wait a turn and have him get a little bit closer to me. There we go. That's right. Get closer to the poison donut. Uh-oh. There we go. Man, who'd have thought that being grossly strong would be really handy with the whole hand-to-hand combat thing? I know there's another one down here. I can see you. Okay. There, here he comes. Here she comes to save the day. There we go. Come on. There we go. A nice, strong. Uh-oh. Okay. Oh, good, it missed. There we go. Oh, it didn't kill him. Mm-mm. Good thing it's not very good. There we go. Alright. Now we get to check this wall to see if there's anything hiding. Just a table. Just a stone bench. Eh, nothing out of the ordinary either. These are just... It's just an old, unused temple by the looks of it. Yep. Nothing special. Okay. Yeah, Small Fry. Hi! How the heck are you? I hope you're doing well. I'm doing fantastic. We are playing a strong, charismatic fellow who is specialized in speech and big guns and outdoorsmen. Because I've never played a character like that before. Oh, crap. I see a scorpion. Scorpone! A small, mutated scorpone. He is going to get strong kicked in the face. You know what? I will... I'll do it. Well, there's really no point doing... Oh, no, there might be a point of doing a targeted one. Dope. Stand your ground! Crunch. Beautiful! That will be challenging, especially with high charisma. Well, I don't have high charisma. I have good charisma and excellent strength. So, but hey, I don't mind a challenge. I don't mind a challenge at all. Also, what is on this guy? Is there any reason why I'd want a scorpion tail? I will take one. To prove that I am strong. Oh my god, I'm not used to having this big of a weight capacity. Holy shit. Oh yeah, I've also specialized in sexy time. I totally took sex appeal. And I don't regret it at all. Okay. So, when you guys play this types of games, I'm assuming... Okay, one, I'll assume for those of you in chat have played this or Fallout 1. And if you haven't, no problem. But if you have, what... Aha, Scorpone. Hey, Cell... Xel, how the heck are you? I hope you're doing well. Hey, that rhymed. But what kind of characters do you like to create? Because I'm really liking this one so far. I know, Small Fry. Not only did he lift it, but he took it from a scorpion. A scorpion that wanted its tail. Are there any hidden goodies here? You're not a hidden goodie. Okay, since I know I'm going to be able to do three attacks, I'm going to just end my turn and kick two more times. There we go. Beautiful! Ooh. Ooh, what are these? Bones! Another spear. I will take it. Now I am Ryan with two spears. No, you're just a burning brazier. All right, let's see what's down this way. See if there's any secrets. Secrets are so fun. Secrets are for everyone. I don't think so. Yeah, I'm in the tutorial level. That's right. I literally just started, Cell. I literally just started. Well, no, I guess not just started would be me outside the temple, but I literally just almost started. The door is locked. Oh! That was an easy lock. I'm not very well skilled at that. But I'll take it. Quick save! There's no... Hey, Axion, whatever makes it fun for... Oh, God! I see a raised plate. Oh, shit, there's traps! Oh, shit! Oh, shit, a ziggurat! Oh, this is where we regret having 4 perception. Just be careful. Think back to med school. Oh, there's a spear. I'm not going back for it. Oh! Besides, there's a spear much closer here! No, there's no need. I already have a spear. Oh, I was hit for 1 hit point. Ouchie. Okay. Well, that's okay. We made it. We made it through the trap room. We sure did. Called a party sniper, gun skill, and decent charisma for followers. That's really neat, Small Fry. That's super neat TNT. Also, I wonder... Ah, never mind. He turned around and saw me. That's okay. We still kick. Get wrecked! Alright. I'm gonna end my turn. Have Scorpone come close to me. And then I'm gonna do this, so when he comes within hand-to-hand combat range, I can smack him twice! Huh? Uno. Oh, damn it. Duo. There we go. Ooh, 6 hit points. That's less good. But I have 1 healing thing. And I'm not in the yellow yet. I won't heal myself until I'm in the yellow or the red. Otherwise, you know. I'm just a little hurt. I'm just a teeny bit hurt. Ooh, it's a chest. A wooden chest. More. Okay, I'll take it. I need that after that scorpion beat the poop out of me. Giant ants and scorpions. Man, if I were afraid of bugs, I would not be in a good time. Ooh, this is neat. A chasm. A chasm that is definitely not out of the ordinary. You know, actually, playing at this a higher resolution, you can appreciate the art a little bit more. I'm gonna actually end my turn. That's right. Oh, that little noise. Did you know that ants and mole rats make the sound noise when you punch them? It's true. It's true, everyone. Wonderful. How far am I from leveling up? Ooh! Pretty soon, actually. It's almost adorable, I know. If it wasn't the call of a death throw of an animal, it would be adorable. Okay, it's all the way up there. I'll squish that bug first, and then I'm going to go for that chest. Because we need everything that we can possibly get. Okay, you know what? Back it up so your timing's perfect. Rayanne, there you go. Look at that. Look at that. So I hope everyone's doing very well over the holiday season. I'm doing very well myself. I'll be visiting family tomorrow, and probably over the next few days. So I thought, hey, you know what? Let's get some streaming in while I can. And nothing says the holidays like a post-apocalyptic wasteland, right? Right? Almost. There you go. Oh, ants. It's oh man, I haven't heard Christmas at Ground Zero forever. That's a Weird Al song, right? I'm pretty sure that's a Weird Al song. It's Christmas at Ground Zero. I almost would play it if I wasn't. The problem is that I don't want my copyrighted music to. Oh, Giant Ant Mist. Just hum it to yourself. Whoever's listening to this right now, when you ever have a moment, go look at Christmas at Ground Zero, and then you can play it over top of this if you really want. And then then everyone's happy. Ooh. Oh, good. Anti-poison. A bottle containing a home-brewed antidote for poison. A milky liquid with floating pieces of rad scorpion flesh. Well, you know, it's true. If you want to have an antidote has to have the bits of the creature in it. You know what I mean? So remember, everyone, if a human being bites you, you better get an antidote that has little bits of people in it. That's right. Now I have a Christmas present in game. I do. Alright, what do we have here? Is an old worn door. Looks like it could be destroyed with a well-placed explosive. I don't have an explosive. Can I just open it usually? Or do I have to find... impenetrable door. Alright. There's obviously an explosive kicking around here somewhere. I just need to find it. It's clearly on this... Smort. Okay, now we quick save. As we all know, Inferno is literally not the best when it comes to things like this, but we're going to try anyway. We're going to go into here. We're going to use that. No, that's on it. Okay, that's right. Okay. So, use. Set the timer for a minute. Now, friggin' drop it. Now, wiggin' run. And we'll be smart. We'll wait around the corner. I would feel really bad for someone who first saw this and they're like, oh, sweet, an explosive. And they, like, carefully try to use it as a trap and time it perfectly to, like, kill an ant or two. Then they realize that they needed it for this, and then they weep softly and load their game from the beginning because they don't know to save, like, at every screen. But I'm a seasoned pro. Kablams! Shablamos! Hey, that was a pretty earth-shattering kaboom. Well, not earth-shattering, but it was shattering. A raised plate. Oh, shit. I narrowly avoided it, though, so it's okay, right? Yep. Alright, where do we want to go? I want to go this way, where the treasure is. I didn't know you had to drop it. Yeah, I probably did the same thing, too. You're, like, running around. Where is it? That was a door-penetrating kaboom. Yeah, good point. Oh, more Scorpone. Come to me, Scorpion. Ooh, you're pretty mobile, aren't you? I think if I time it out right here, we'll be okay, though. I do like how if you don't do anything, you're... One more. Your AC goes up. There we go. I think that should do it. Oh, no, it wasn't. Okay, hold up. That should do it. There we go. Stupid scorpion. Uh-oh. This is why you don't call them stupid. So I could be trying to do a kick and then end the turn and increase my AC, but there's no need. Offense is the best defense. Sometimes. Sometimes defense is the best offense. It all depends on the situation and how many scorpions you gotta kick with your foot. Okay, I'm gonna back up one. There we go. Oh, so close. Well, not so close, but pretty close. Once again, I'm not going to take their tails all the time. No siree, Bob. I'm going to just... Ah, perfect. Take all. And now we run, just to save everyone a little bit of time and effort. And, of course, we're going to quick save. And we're going to continue. And, yes, I'm walking because of raised plates. And also, it makes more sense. If you're in a weird, scary area, you don't just be like, oh, hey, I'm going to run everywhere like a madman and not look where I'm going. I totally... Oh, there's two of them! Oh, there's two of them! Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Alright, we're gonna try kick you. Damn it. There we go. 3 hit points. There we go. Oh my god. Oh my god, Axians. I don't even know what to think about that. I don't. Wow. For those of you who are watching this VOD later on, Axian asked, what kind of sex appeal character is this? Not constantly chasing tail. It's a stone bench. That's not out of the ordinary. Who'd have thought? There's nothing in there. Okay. Hello. This is Cameron, a fellow tribesman. I'm a young man with bulging muscles and a very confident air about him. Oh, really? Oh, really? Greetings, Raya. I have the honor of being your final challenge. To continue your quest, you must defeat me in unarmed combat. Shall we begin? Well, I have some questions for you first. What would you like to know? Why do we have to fight? The path of the Chosen One is not an easy trial to walk, Rayan. You'll be faced with many challenges throughout your lifetime, and the most difficult of these will be dealing with your fellow man. There will come a time when diplomacy and tact will prove to be useless, and your hand must be raised instead. This challenge prepares you to face another human. Look him in the eyes, and know that you may have to kill him. And we're going to be a smartass and disagree with them. I disagree with you. I think that a peaceful solution to any problem is possible. You may be correct, Rayan, but it's not our current situation. You must defeat me to succeed at your trial. Look, I don't know all your strengths and weaknesses, and you don't know mine. Accidents do happen, so what if one of us inadvertently kills the other? Let's just end this now, rather than take the chance, okay? I see your point. I wouldn't want to be responsible for killing you, when all I meant to do was test your mettle. Very well, you may pass, Chosen One. Thanks, I'll see you back at the village. Aha! Look at me. Look how smart I am. Now, I don't know if I'm going to play my guy as goody-goody two-shoes as the, as my last character. I probably will. I don't like playing assholes in RPGs. There is that funny meme of, like, in GTA, you'll just kill anyone, but if you have a tough dialogue choice, you know, you're crying about it. But I definitely want my guy to be, you know, he doesn't have a high intelligence, right? His intelligence is fair, but not even average. So he's less than a bigger, he has less intelligence than the average person. But I like to think that he's like, do you know people who aren't really all that smart, but they like to sound smart, or they just like to win, or they just like to be right? I think that might be who Ryan is. Oh, the suit! Yeah, small fry, pseudo-intellectual. Hey, I gained 15 karma. You were once more in the village of your birth. I gained 15 karma, I passed the trials of Oreo, I've gone up a level and gained some experience points. Well, no, that might think of like level 2. I don't know, I'll just call it 1. There. Quiet, dog! That sexy, sexy jumpsuit. Alright. Sex appeal, sex appeal. Karma. Oh yeah, I got... So a part of this mod that I have, the community restoration project, did return a few things to the game that was removed in the American release. And one was the virgin status. You really need to get out more. Your sexual exploits have been, well, two-dimensional. Oh, my God. And we have decent karma, and we, of course, are idolized in Oreo. And we've killed 12 giant ants and 9 red scorpions. Holy shit, that's actually quite good. All right, so all that we have to increase are these things. So I'm going to increase this so it's at least 40. And I'm going to increase unarmed a bit. And I'm going to increase my outdoorsman a bit. Aww. 48? Because until I get big guns, I'm probably going to use unarmed. Because I just am. A cat's paw in my inventory? That would have been hilarious. Okay, that's good enough for me. What the heck are these? A plant of the dark soul. What? Alright. There's Cameron. Hey Cameron, what up? It is good to see you again, Chosen One. How may I help you? Just I say hi. I'll see you later. Oh, actually, can we barter? What do you have? Nothing. You're useless to me, Cameron. Useless! See you later. Who the heck is trying to attack me? Is it these things? I think it is those things. But I'm pretty sure there's a quest for them if I remember correctly. I see a pot. Stands Hakunin, the village shaman. He appraises you with crazy eyes from somewhere in the world only he inhabits.
Greetings, Chosen.
Oh, God.
Why does the earth before me warm to the touch of your passing?
I'm a little hurt. Would you be able to heal me?
Chosen, once again, the wholeness of your being is like a land blessed.
Once again, we're going to be a know-it-all. So that means I'm better, right?
Please reveal to clouded eyes the purpose of your passage.
Well, I'm heading out. I was hoping just this one time. You know, you talk like a real person, like me.
The views of the world are many. A lesson you will learn soon. Perhaps before you reap the experiences of life, you would bestow a kindness?
Well, did you ask me to do you a favor? Is that what you meant? Because I'm so smart. If so, sure. Why not? I'll help you out.
The plants of Dark Soul have infested my garden again. Many seasons have touched my bones, and I am too frail for the fight, which is eternal in nature. I ask that you be my champion.
Well, sure, for a price.
To ask payment for a gift will bring you less than the gift itself. I will give you such, and add the lesson of your self-disappointment at the receiving.
We're going to pretend, so I knew what he was talking about. But I think my guy probably listened to what he wanted to hear. So he'd be like, okay, yeah, sure. Well, good enough. Where's your garden?
Surely you remember it is to the northeast, foolish one.
Thank you. I actually understood that. Oh, boy. Do I regret being an asshole? Not really. Good heart, but just a bit of a dick bag. Alright, off we go. I realize that... Ooh. Oh yeah, that's right. There's these little thorns, too, that I could pick up. But first, me smash. Nope. Me end turn, then me smash. Aha. Take that. And that. Oh my god. Whoa. Alright, so you're kind of tough. Holy moly. Oh good. As long as we're all assholes, then we're good. Surprise! Uh-oh. Just chopping the trees with my leg. Rip. Oh, I like how it changed color. Very cool. Also, plant spikes. What are they? What does it mean? An organic seed spike that the carnivorous plants spit at potential food or seed carriers. Oh, it's a throwing weapon. I wonder if it's worth anything. We're gonna try to take it and find out. Why not? And if they're worth nothing, then, well, we'll dump them. Beautiful. Oh my god. Small fry Y. Also, it's good to see you, by the way, my friendo. It's always good to see you. Also, spooky skeleton skull pole. With human skulls attached, do you think that's appropriate, shaman?
Ah, you return the spirit of the dweller to the world and bring a smile to the soul of an old man in passing. For this, I give you powders of healing.
Ooh.
Remember, they fog the mind as they cleanse the body.
All right, well, thank you.
And also, will I mix the brock flower with the Xander root together whenever you bring both to me? May your pathways be true and your heart follow suit.
Where can I find these
Look
things?
Look to the north, chosen, and the way will be open.
Okay, thanks. Can we barter? You have nothing for me. Oh, these poor, poor... Okay, thanks. Bye. Oh, God. Oh, God, I hope they weren't trying to mate with me. Oh, thank you, Small Fry. Hello. Who are you? A female villager. Hello, I hear you are the chosen one. Now perhaps our village can be saved. what can you tell me about the traders who trade with us? Oh, it's not my place to deal with the traders. Talk to Minok, the guardian of the Great Bridge. He sees them all. Where is the Great Bridge located? Good joke, Chosen One. You know where it is. That way, to the south. Well, thank you. Goodbye. Yes, I knew that. I'm a genius. I knew that, of course. The elder of our village. Okay, well, let's save before we do anything too crazy. In case she kicks us out or something. I'm not done exploring this village, gosh darn it.
Congratulations, Chosen One. You have survived the Temple of Trials. Are you ready for your quest?
Yes, of course.
Then take this flask. It is from the Holy Vault 13. Vic, a trader in Klamath, brought it to us. He may know where the vault is. You may also need some of what they call money. Here.
Yeah, money. Thank you for the money. Mr. Krabs, why did you build a second Krabby Patty right next to the other one? Money. Alright, anyway. Is there anything more you can tell me?
I cannot help much. So much has been lost from the long ago. What wisdom do you seek?
Oh, tell me more about this G.E.C.K that I'm supposed to find.
It is a holy artifact. The Garden of Eden creation kit. The discs promise it will make our lands green and our village prosperous. It will save us. More, I do not know.
Klamath doesn't sound like a disease to me, but I do confuse it a little bit with Klendathu, which is the planet that the space marines or the marines land on in frickin' I almost said super troopers. No, starship troopers. There's more I want to know.
What do you need?
How do I get to Klamath?
Klamath is
Klamath, sorry. Potato, potato. There are other things I would learn.
What do you need?
I want to see if you'll barter with me. No more money? Alright. Okay, well, I could ask where is Vault for 13, but she doesn't know. That's why she gave me the flask. So that is all I will ask for. Let's look at the new thing. Let's look at this money. Oh. It actually is Vic's water flask. This relic of the vault was probably used to contain some sacred sacrament. The holy number 13 is emblazoned on the side of the precious link to your people's past and hopeful future. The holy 13. Whoa, I'm really thirsty, but the well's broken. Well then, let's see if our horrible, horrible repair skill can fix it. You repair the well! Oh, introductory areas, you're so nice. Hey, thanks for fixing that well. You're welcome. Ooh. Is there anything in this pot? No. Oh, this tribal music. We're gonna say this is my tent. Because I totally want to see if there's anything on these shelves that I would take with me, because this is my tent. It's Xander Root. I will take Xander Root. And if I can find some rock flower, oh my goodness, wouldn't I be in just a fantastic situation, wouldn't I? Ooh, a shovel. You never know when you need a shovel, right? It's a shovel for digging ditches and stuff. Sweet. You never know when you might need to dig some stuff. Why don't you bother my nephew? Can't you see I'm busy? Is this your nephew? Hello, you are the chosen one. Where can I find more healing powder? Alright, I saw him. You have anything? And stuff. Yeah, well, you know what? There are traders that come, like Vic, so she probably got the money from Vic. It's a stone monument. Hello, Lucas. It's the chief warrior of my tribe. He sounds important. So, there you are, Chosen One. How goes your quest? Pretty good. Maybe you need a warrior's help. Sure, what can you help me with? I know how to fight with fists and feet. Think you can learn that? Ooh, what can you teach me? You know all I can teach you, Chosen One. Good luck on your quest. Oh. Thanks for nothing. I guess that's how I learned all my awesomeness. Is from him. I'm just looking around the village one last time before I leave. Gods give you speed and bring back Eden before it's too late. I don't think anyone has anything for me to trade. No, you don't. This hurts me. This hurts my soul. But you know what? Oh. Never mind. Female villager, Jordan, twirling his spear as usual. Oh, Jordan and his crazy spear. Chosen One, the way you use a spear, you must be meat for the geckos in no time. I can show you a few tricks. Yeah, sure. This will take a little while. You're a swift student. It looks like you've learned all I can teach you. Thanks. That's going to help a lot. Now, if we look at my character sheet, my melee weapons, ooh, are actually quite good. Oh. So I think I am going to keep one of these spears. Yes, indeed. Thanks for helping me out as a way of saying thank you. I'm not going to rob from you, but I am going to see what's in this. No, oh, there's nothing here. Just beds. Oh, the Brahmin that are dying and pooping. Your young cousin Nagar. Ryan and Nagar. Actually, that works quite well. You don't see his dog Smoke anywhere. Oh my god, where's Smoke? Oh my god, where's Smokums? Olmec. Olmec. Maybe. Cousin, I'm glad to see you. I need your help. What do you need help with? Smoke ran off into the hunting grounds and hasn't come back, and now Morlis won't let me go find him. She says it's too dangerous and he's just a dog. But I was going to... go anyway. But now that you're here, you can do it and I won't get in trouble. Sure, where are the hunting grounds? Did you hit your head with a rock? They're on the far side of Hawkinstead, north of the village. I'll be back with him soon. And because I don't want to miss out on Oh, I thought I was going to get repeat dialogue, so I shouldn't have done that. I asked what about the traders that deal with it. They're nothing to us. To scavenge the dying course of the waste to live. Thank you. Okay, I don't think I can pick these or anything. Nope. Alright. Let's go save Smoke. Yeah, that's the worst way to die, is when you poop at the same time. It's true. It's true, Small Fry. Hunting grounds? Nope. Ooh, but hey. I see rocks. Did it give me anything? No. Oh, okay. It's just letting you know that it's installed. Okay, that sounds fair. Alright, let's see what's over here. Aha, Brock Flower and other things. And geckos! Xander Root. And I totally want to level up again, so let's smash some gosh darn geckos. Let's smoosh them. Come at me! I'm starting to regret these decisions. Alright. Uh-oh. What if I kick them? That's slightly better. I guess I should have left them alone, shouldn't I? Yeah, I think I should have left these stupid things alone. I might just load my... Yeah, I think we're gonna just... If we don't... Okay. Let's just load. If the geckos aren't gonna hurt me, then I'm not gonna hurt them. Doggo, where are you? I'll save you. I wonder if I can get this Xander root. Oh yeah, the geckos will leave me alone. Okay, sweet. I don't know if it's because of my outdoorsman or what. Come on. Come on! Aww. What a tease you are. Oh, shit. The goo burns me. It burns us, Precious. Woof woof. That's a good doggo. That's a good smoke. Okay, careful, smoke. Careful. Don't step in the goo. The goo is lava. The goo is radioactive lava. Okay, I'm getting me some Xander root, damn it. There we go. Brock flower, that is. Give me that Brock flower. That sweet, sweet Brock. So now I should have 2 Xander root and 2 Brock flower? I do! Okay, good. I'll get that made then. That's right, doggo. Beautiful. Oh, that's one happy dog. You found smoke. Thanks, smoke. You're a bad dog. You're welcome. Bye-bye. All right. First things first, crazy old man.
Chosen. My garden is well. How is yours?
Good. I want you to make some healing powder for me.
May this be of no use.
Okay, thank you. Oh, like, yeah, alright, perfect. Can you heal me as well?
Ah, chosen. My garden is well. How the pleasure of these words fills me. Alas, the gods whisper for my ear. Goodbye.
Alright, bye. Love you. Alright, well, I guess we'll just... Are there any more named people? Nope. I think we'll just continue. But we're going to give her the old Saverino, just in case. Alright, who we have here? Tribeswoman. Tribesman. Let's see what's in here. Nothing. We'll see what's in here. I have a feeling it's gonna be nothing! I was so right. It's a finely crafted pot. Okay, and here is the bridge guard. Actually, this is a pretty good setup. I mean, if anyone tries to invade you, you just cut the bridge, right? I mean, you can't get out, but at least you won't get slaughtered. Hello, Chosen One. Off to find the Geck? Yes, but before you go, I'd like to ask you some questions. We want to know. Well, can you tell me the men who trade with our village? The traders, they come from Klamath. Or, I can't remember if it's Klamath or Klamath, she said. I think it was Klamath. About every 2 months. There won't be another one here for a month or more, but Klamath's only a few days east of here. What can you tell me about this object I have from the Sacred Vault? Looks like a metal water gourd. Maybe the vault sent it to us as an omen. Can you tell me who brought this item to our village? I don't remember his name, just that he was old and loud. Too loud for proper manners. But he knew many things. He was from Klamath, east, like I said. Do you have anything to barter? Oh my god, you have a knife. Let's see how much these seeds are worth. 0. Wow. Totally worth it. You know what? You get free seeds, bud. And you know what? I already have one spear, right? So I might as well have a knife and a spear. You never know. And I can get rid of these stupid crappy seeds that are worthless. Yeah, alright, offer that. That's a good trade. Yeah, damn straight it is. Unless the invaders can fly. Okay, yeah, good point, Cell. Good point. Hopefully the flying Mothman won't get us. One to 10, 3 to 14. And I think I'm pretty much the same to use them, so that's fine. Alright, I'm going to grab a drink of water here real quick before we go off into the map. Look at my flowing locks of hair. Isn't that amazing? I think that's pretty amazing. Alright. Okay, give her the old little quick save, and I will be right back. Okay. Let's continue, shall we? Alright, to the east. Well, I wonder where we're gonna go. A few days? This is more than a few days. Alright, 3:30. That's... Now I'm moving around because of the time. There we go, 8:20 in the morning, that works. And we're greeted by a grunt from a Brahmin. A regular domesticated Brahmin. I thought it said a regular disgruntled Brahmin, but I guess I'd be pretty disgruntled too. Alright. We'll just save it as 4. What do we have here? Some sort of notice board. Let's examine it. There are several things here. Some ads, job notices, and even a drawing. Looks as though some of these have been here for a while. Alright, so closer look about the drawing. Something about booze, a bath, lizard hides, rats. Someone's gone missing. It's only one of the heads that are disgruntled. The other one's happy with the situation. Well, that's good. Let's start from the top. A crude drawing of what looks like a Brahmin with a big X through it and the words Tor scrawled underneath. Okay, I'll look at another notice. Something about booze. Booze. Got your attention, didn't I? Bum leg prevents business. Need help refueling still. Speedy and reliable type needed. See Whiskey Bob over at Ma Buckner's place. Alright. Something about a bath. Feeling grubby? Nothing makes a feller feel better than a nice bath. 3 fun-filled types to choose from. Featuring the beautiful and talented Jenny, late of the den. See Big Nose Sal at the bathhouse for more exciting details. Ooh. How about something about some lizard hides? Top dollar for top pelts. You have gecko pelts? I have money. Golden gecko pelts especially welcome. See me first. Sajag owner operator Golden Gecko Tavern. Let's look at another notice. Here's something about rats. Too many Dan rats in Trapper Town. Come and get them all, and you all come and get them all you can eat, Slim. Okay, another notice. Something about old stuff here. Genuine antiques. They don't make them like they used to. In fact, they mostly don't make them at all. If you want the good stuff, see Vic the Trader, East Side, downtown. Okay. It looks like someone's gone missing. Missing person. Has anyone seen Smiley the Trapper? Smiley's about 6 feet tall, clean and housebroken mostly. Disappeared up north, and I kind of miss him. Arden Buckler. Alright, that's all I need to know for now. Look at all this stuff. What is this? The Buccaneer House sign. E, the Boogie Monster. Oh, fucking kids, I swear. You see a very large man carved into dust with a small smile and a blank look on his face. I have played Fallout 2 before. It was a while ago, and I never beat it. I've never beat it. So, and I don't remember a whole lot. I remember some of it. Like Smiley the Trapper, I remember where he's at. But it's like it is a lot of things, right? I'm gonna remember clearly stuff near the beginning of the game. As the game goes on, I'm gonna forget more and more until I just don't know anymore. Me, Tor. Nice to meet you, Tor. Anything happening here lately? Bugman, take Moomoo's at night. Tor's scared. Help, Tor? I can't help you with that. Goodbye. We're gonna save it, and then we're gonna try help him with that. I think it's gonna be a little too difficult, though, because of his Moomoo's. Zug Zug? Oh, no. Ah! Okay, wait. See, this is why we save our game. This is why we save our game. Okay. We won't read the notices again because we don't need to. Sure, I'll help you. You help Tor, Moomoo's Field, point east of here. Now, yes? Sure, I'll help. I'll help you now. Oh, that's no problem. Well, it wouldn't be any problem if I could actually kick them. There we go. Who are these guys? Hold up. I guess I'll quick save it. I can always go back to save 4 if I need to. Yeah, okay, I've noticed that, Cell, and I will probably take these jobs at first opportunity. What the heck are you doing here? Are you trying to help us or not? We have a job for you if you're interested. Yeah, I'm interested. Tell us about this job. Well, there's this thing that could use some help with. What's that? Okay, here's the deal. Well, we need some help in liberating some Brahmin from that idiot Tor. You should have trouble with that. Just talk him out of them. What do you say? No, I don't think I want to do that after all. Word to the wise, you just better not say nothing to nobody, because if you do, that would make us very angry, and you don't want to see us angry. Now, do we promise not to tell anyone? Or do we say, screw you? Once again, I think this guy has ego problems, so he's... I don't want to see you at all. Oh, God. Alright. So that's how it's going to be, huh? Welcome to Kicksville. Population U. Okay. They hurt really hard, though. Okay. Okay. Alright, sir. I might be dead. Man, am I ever glad I saved this stuff beforehand. And down I go. And down I go. That's a bleeder. You have died. Yep, I sure have. You know what? Let's just kill the scorpions. Tor likes Rhea, and Tor thank Bugman bad, and I'll let Bugman eat Moomoos. I hope that can put the. I hope we can put a stop to these things attacking your Moomoos. I mean, Brahmin. I don't think anything would attack with both of us here. Okay. Alright, Scorpones. Yep. Nice. Critically hit. 60 XP. Darn. Oh, crap, I'm poisoned. This is the first time in Fallout 1, and since Fallout 1, I've never been poisoned in Fallout 1, so it's actually really funny. I got poisoned this time. Wow, unarmed damage is 1 to 16. That's quite good. Alright, I'm going to save it again in case I get poisoned again, and I'm completely boned. We're gonna get ready with the spear too, I think. In fact, I suppose we could always throw the spear. Oh god, my throwing is terrible. Never mind. There we go. Yeah, spear might be a better way to go. And now I am going to move forward one, because I know I'm going to get two more hits on this. Because I always win the initiative against these things. Uh-oh. Damn it! Okay, wait. I'm gonna focus on killing the rest of these scorpions, and then I will, then I'm gonna cure my poison. Oh god, it's gonna get me. Oh, come on, 62% chance. There we go. You've killed all the rod scorpions that were threatening the Brahmin. Sweet. Now the question is, what's in here? Some small rocks. Rat scorpion limbs. These rat scorpion pincers are hollowed out and have a strap with a broken buckle at the end. What? Meat jerky. These smoke and dried chunks of beast flesh remain chewy-licious and even somewhat nutritious for years and years and years and years. And they're mine now. I don't know who lives here, but they have jerky and limbs. It's kind of weird. And a table. Oh, and they're gone now. Interesting. Bug's dead. Moomoo's safe. Tor thanks you. No reward? Alright, fine. Be that way. Oh my goodness, I'm right outside Vic's. Vic's sign. Oh sweet, I can look through his window. This is a deck of cards for collectible card game. Looks like it'd be an expensive hobby if you got hooked. We got more of the water flasks, some beer, some booze, and some Nuka-Cola. But where is Vic? Oh, tragic cards. Tragic the Gathering, I'm sure. Don't worry, I'll release a digital version. Ooh, I set off a trap and we're hit for 10 points of damage. It appears to be locked. Lockpick? Damn it. I might have to blow that door open. Unless I find a key somewhere. Maybe a key's in this tire. No. Maybe I'll have to ask around a little bit. Tragic the maddening. Oh wait, we're gonna close this door. Because it's only polite. Right? Oh, I had the hand icon. There we go. Ooh, bathhouse. I'm sure we could use a bath, right? Sure. Plump older woman with a large nose. A girly poster. My name's Sally Dutton, but mostly they call me Big Nose Sally. I'm the owner of this here bathhouse. We have a whole house full of special attendant baths for you to pick from. Gee, Miss Sally, I just wanted a regular bath. You don't have a bubble bath, do you? What kind of special attendant baths do we have here? Reading the answers already. The special baths that we have available vary in cost by the amount of time the gal spends with you and any special services that you take advantage of. You mean I get to be with a real live girl? Sign me up! The baths that we have available are the washcloth hand wipe, a brief full body wash, and lastly, the round-the-world full squeaky clean servicing officer offered by the beautiful and talented Jenny, recently trained at the finest house in the den. The hand wipe, the full body wash, what's that going to cost? Beautiful and talented. I got to hear more about the round the world full squeaky clean wash. $125, that's most of my money. Well, I'm sure that your round the world trip servicing with beautiful Jenny will be experienced that you'll save for quite some while. Maybe I should hear about the other bath choices. What's the hand wipe? Well, for an attractive individual like yourself, that would only cost $25. And how about the full body wash? You could use a bit of real scrubbing. Don't your travels know about soap? Oh well, that'll cost you $70 for the brief full body wash, but I'm sure you'll be happy with the results. Yeah, time to shed that virgin karma. We'll do with that. I think you'll really enjoy this. That was special. You're wonderful. Next. She didn't even look me in the eye. Ah, yeah, there it goes. Oh, that's funny. You know how to whistle, don't ya? Aren't you a cutie? Thank you. The woman who was hired to have sex with me and wipe me down said I was cute. She must mean it, right? Looks like a lot of folks just can't seem to get clean enough. I want to barter with you, Big Nose Sally. Oh. Oh my god. I could get... You know what? I don't need this anymore. Give me money for that. And give me money for that knife. Because I think if I'm going to do any hand-to-hand tool, I'll use the spear. And I'd rather have 45 money. Because you took a bunch of it. So I got wiped down for, 25 monies and a sword. Oh, okay, no, I'm gonna leave. I'll come back later. Bye! Okay. Okay, what is this? The Buckner House. I'm actually quite hurt. Old, sturdy woman with a tired smile. And a person enjoying a drink. Well, hello there. My name's Arden Buckner, and this is my place. Say, you didn't see a trapper named Smiley outside of town, did you? He's been gone for too long. Never shall him go off on that fool quest of his. No, I haven't seen anyone by that name. Tell me more about him. Well, Smiley and me were getting downright serious with each other. I thought I'd finally gotten him to agree to settle down here and help me run this place, but he said he needed to go off on one last quest. A quest? Well, he called it a quest. He told me he thought he knew where all the golden geckos came from, and he wanted to find out for sure. He thought that maybe it was some kind of magical spring, or maybe a hidden cave or vault of some sort. Well, I don't really know what he said, but he seemed to real excited about going. But I shouldn't have let him go. He's 2 weeks later getting back than he said he'd be, and I'm a little worried. Well, I'm going to try to look for him for you, but I don't have any idea. Oh, thank you. Let me mark on your map where he talked about looking. I sure hope you can find him. He isn't much, but I still love him, and I miss him more than I thought. If you could, please find him for me. Let me ask you something. I was wondering, are you the person to talk to about local news and events? You should talk to my daughter, Madia, about that. I just don't really keep track of what's going on lately. Just too much keeping an eye on my own business. Alright. Information about something else. I'd like to buy something. I'll just handle the rules here. If you don't want to buy a trade, talk to my daughter, Madia. Oh, okay. Is there anything that you can barter for me, though? No. Yes, I wonder, small fry. Okay, thanks. Goodbye. Is this Madia? Probably. She has a scowl on her face. My name is Madia Buckner. I take care of trading and drinks here. I just don't tolerate any tribals messing up our family's place. So you better watch your steps here, or you'll end up like Sulik. What do you want? Sulik? Well, I want to buy some things. You want to barter? I'm always looking for good quality gecko pelts, and I pay a fair price for them, too. Okay, I'll trade with you. Gecko pelt, A. Ooh, stim pack. Ooh, knife. Combat knife. Ooh, boozahal. And a rope. And gecko pelts. Ooh, and leather armor. How much? Oh, so much. So much money. Worth nothing. Worth a little bit. Worth nothing. Worth a tiny bit. Let's see. Oh, no. That's tough. Tell me about something else. I have some questions for you. Questions, huh? Taking you doesn't seem to be get my work any closer to being finished. Well, can you tell me about this Sulik guy? Sulik's a tribal that's working here to pay off a debt he foolishly incurred. He's not a slave. We don't have slaves here in Klemeth. Paying off a debt? What do you mean? Well, you see, Sulik got real upset one night and had too much booze. Then when he was good and drunk, he busted up the place. He did nearly $500 worth of damage, just now getting the place repaired. Why do you get so upset? He said he found out that his sister had been kidnapped by slavers, but you have to ask him more about it. He's here until he can pay off the rest of the damage he did while he was drunk. How much does he have to work off? He still has to pay off $350. If he weren't so lazy and shiftless, wow, racist, it would go quicker for him. He's not leaving here until his debt is paid in full. That's a lot of money. He might be here for a long time. Well, he may be slow, but he does sort of grow on you after a while. Oh my god. She's in love with him. Oh, what if someone else paid for his damages? I don't know if anyone would want to. $350. Well, I don't have that much money to spare anyway. Goodbye.
What can we and I do you for?
Hey, Knack. Who's we?
The spirits with me, friend. They be all around. Sometimes talk.
What spirits?
Spirits be everywhere. Travel with we and I. Grampy Bone do most of talking.
Who's Grampy Bone?
Him strong spirit. Much honor carrying him.
Is Grampy Bone the bone in your nose?
Keep him close. Easier to touch his spirit. That's why he talk the most.
Oh, I see, of course. Game goes well so far. Can I ask you something else?
No many things. Travel from great saltwater to home of biting lizards.
Biting lizards?
Geckos. The little dudes don't bite hard. It's the goldens. They go through your leg like an old pipe stem.
Let me ask you something else. What do you mean by great saltwater?
The tribe's home is next to great saltwater. 2 moons from here, friend.
I see.
We and I be glad to answer.
Why do you travel so much?
Trader named Vic supposed to be here. He be saying he know about slavers. We show up, didn't peep him. Get pretty hot.
Oh, let me ask you something else. Glad to answer. So, what are you doing here?
Slavers got our sis. Thought Vic be having information. Couldn't peep him. Got PO'd. Drank like a fish. Spirits of anger and chaos pop out, and now we have to pay some coin to make it right.
Oh, boy. Small fry, yeah, he might be a streamer. Grampy Bone might be, you know, his biggest subscriber, who knows. You're looking for Vic the Traitor? I was looking for Vic the Traitor.
Vic the Traitor, more like. Comes to village, says he knows about slavers. Tells us to come see him. We go. He ain't there.
So she was taken by slavers.
Sis went trading at another village and never come back. We and I go look for her.
Did you find her?
One survivor. Dude was in bad shape. Said evil warriors came with magic torches. Fire would lick tribe warriors and they'd go to the spirit.
What about your sister?
The evil warriors tied up the rest and took off. Sis with them. Friend, we be finding her or dying trying.
Sorry to hear that.
We and I be glad to answer.
You have any local information?
What can we and I do you for?
Have you heard of a Garden of Eden creation kit?
Never heard of it. But Maida's been keeping us busy.
Maida?
She's the boss. We pay off and go find Sis. What can we and I do you for?
What's going on in town?
Oh, busy place. Bugmen snatching cattle. Spirits walking. Smiley missing.
Bugman?
Tor be telling us about bugs that walk on 2 feet and steal Brahmin. Shook him up.
Oh, those guys were in... Oh, interesting. Let me ask you something else.
You have more questions for Sulik?
What about these walking spirits?
The canyon east of Herd area supposed to have a walking, howling spirit, shaking the locals. Grampy Bone don't say a word, though.
Hmm, interesting.
You have more questions for Sulik?
Tell me about Smiley.
Smiley's a good hunter. Say he looking for the golden gecko's nest. Didn't come back. You have more questions for Sulik? What can we and I do you for?
Can I trade or a healer a room?
So many questions. Maida takes care of trade here, and her mother, Arden, takes care of the rooms. No shaman in town, but you may be able to trade for medicine.
All right, that's all I need to know. Goodbye. All right, so I think Sulik would be handy to have around. Stay away from the Duntons, huh? Don't go wandering at night, or they're gonna get you. All right. All right, so Ariel helped what's-his-face. Who's this? The sickly man in dirty robes. Hello there, I haven't seen you in Klamath before. I'm Aldo, the town greeter. It's my job to greet anyone new in town and to answer any questions that they might have about our bucolic little burg. Welcome to Klamath. Who might you be? I'm Ryan of Arroyo. I'm the chosen one. Hey! Sullivan, bull guy in the corner. I may do that. Meska man, good to see you, by the way. The Chosen One. Oh, mighty Rayan, you must be very important and powerful among your people. Surely one of your great stature would be happy to follow a custom of tipping the town greeter. How's five? Thanks for the money, friend. I'm going to use it to get some medicine for my dry throat. Consider yourself officially greeted. Do you have any questions? Yes. Find a geck. A geck heck. You mean a gecko? Never heard of a geck before, but I know about geckos. Tell me about geckos. A gecko is a large lizard that's hunted by trappers around these parts for its meat and hide, but it sure is a lot of work to catch them dang critters, and dangerous, too. My advice to a friend, avoid it. It's far too much work. One more thing. You can always buy things at Buckner's house and also at the Golden Gecko. Sometimes they even have healing herbs available. Alright. Not that they give you for my condition. They're skin flints, just a little behind you. To the cold and rain. Okay. And what do folks do here? Farm, raise Brahmin, but trapping geckos is what most people do. I know what a gecko is. Alright, that's all I need to know. Yeah, I already went to Fix House. Sullivan. You mean Sulik? I already spoke with Sulik. Oh, never mind. Hello, Sullivan. Hello, stranger. My name's Whiskey Bob. That's Whiskey Bob. That's not Sullivan. My name's Ryan. Nice to meet you, Whiskey Bob. Always nice to find another drinking buddy. Want to buy me a drink? Talking always makes me thirsty. Sure. Thanks for the drink, partner. Now that my whistle's wet, I feel that I can share a little problem I have. Hey, maybe you can help me out. How can I help you out? Well, you see, I have a little side business I need some help attending to. I have a moonshine still out in town that needs to be fueled every so often. Since a gecko dumb bit my leg, I can't hobble out to it before it runs out of fuel. If I tell you where it is, will you refuel it for me? It'll be worth $50. Okay. All I have to do is find a little shack just south of town, go inside and dump some firewood into the still. Then come back here and I'll give you the money. But it needs to be done within the next day or my batch of hooch will go bad. Alright, that seems pretty easy. Alright, no problem. See you in a day. Alright, to the south. I'll just quick save it. It's too late! Mezca, it's too late! I have to warn you, I might not do things optimally. Ooh, a golden gecko. I'll hunt these geckos a little bit later. Oh shit. Oh shit, they're coming for me. I might be bummed though. Seven hit points. I might be better doing strong kicks. A little bit better. Oh no! Oh no! Yeah, gecko's too tough. Oh, I got one though. Maybe I'll make it. If I get really lucky. If I get really lucky. And I didn't. Alright. You're dead. Yep, I sure am. I sure am, friend. Okay, so first things first. I don't think we're going to be very good with that spear. I think we're better to have some healing juice on us. There we go. A little bit of the old healing powder. Maybe we can just kite one of these little bastards. Oh, damn. Actually, this works out quite well. He said, missing 4 times in a row, and then getting bitten horribly. There we go. There we go. Okay, I got a crazy idea. Let's do a kick and then a turn. Increase our AC. I don't think that's actually doing me any good. How does he look? Almost dead. Oh shit. Now I'm almost dead. This is a horrible idea. Oh, and there's not. Oh, hold up a second. Now I know why. Now I know why you said that. Oh, shit. Now I know why you said that, though. Because, if I remember correctly, We gotta be learn how to skin geckos. So hopefully it's I have a day, right? So as long as I don't sleep, I'm okay. Now I remember. Go back to the golden gecko. The golden gecko! Okay. I will go back to the golden gecko. Short, swarthy man smiling at me. Hey there, friend. A little bird me told you that you know where old Whiskey Bob has his still. I sure would like to know where that is. I don't think I want to tell you that. Why do you want to know where it is? The story is that Bob's homemade hooch is making people sick. I'll pay $50 just to know where the still is, and then we can get the town council to shut him down, smiles warmly. I don't think I should tell you where the still is. Forgot I mentioned it then, not a big thing. This ain't your kind of place, punk. Hello, ma'am. Bar patron. Bar patron. Eating some jerky. Well, I might as well just ask to people. Your name Tor? Ha ha ha. Your mama ain't in here, kid. Try the bathhouse. Aww, that's not nice. You're not much to look at. Well, you're just jealous. Well, it's just about my educated opinion, but I can see by the way you move you could deal with a few pointers. Pointers? With what? But the sweet science, of course, is sport and art. Tell me magic? Can you teach me magic spells? Sure, and Begora. I can teach you about the wee folk, leprechauns, spriggans, bensies, and the like. Would you like to know? Yeah, teach away. Did you hear that? I got myself a live one here. Wants to hear about the fairies and the wee goblins and such. Ha ha ha. He doubles over in laughter. Here, lad, have a drink on me. That's your ticket to the realms of the fey folks. All right. Well, the drink's just to start. You have to find a fairy mound. What then? Oh, my God. Teach me magic, missile. Well, you sit in the mound and wait until you can see the fairy circle in the dew. And then if you drop... Oh, my God. And if you jump into the fairy ring, you'll be made to dance until dawn with the wee folk. If you survive, they'll steal away to the land of the fairy. Hee hee ha ha. How'd you find all this out? Oh, it's in me blood, of course. Aaron Gobra. Yeah, you go brag about Aaron. Let me ask you something else. Well now, what have we here? Looks like you didn't know much about the sweet science at all, do ye? What are you talking about? It was just my educated opinion, but by the way you move, you can use some pointers. Pointers with what? About the sweet science. What are you talking about? Pugilism! The manly art of hand-to-hand combat, that's what I mean. I guess I could use some help with that. Well, let's go outside and see what I can teach you, you see. It's all about getting your whole wee body to snap up like a whip. Uh-huh. Several sweaty hours later. So you see what you got been doing wrong? Yes, thanks for taking the time. For helping me out. Yeah, let me give you some money for that. No, I couldn't take your money from you. It's your own pleasure to teach you what I want to know. Take darn good care of yourself now. You got real potential. Thank you! My unarmed is now 75. Oh, my melee and my unarmed. That's exciting. I don't see anyone around. Alright, well, here, I'm gonna give this a save. I guess I don't know how to. Well, maybe if I kill them, I can still skin them afterwards. I don't know. There's plenty more to skin that I need to anyway, so in the meantime, let's just try to get to this still and get my 50 money dollars. Oh god, there's golden geckos around. Oh shit. Oh, I was like, hey, I'm doing really well. He says, not doing very well. Kick, yo. Yes. Good. Ow. Uh-oh. Ah, I do have to learn about skinning first. Okay. Fair enough, but you know what? That's alright. That's what, first of all, that's this sick save is all about. Second of all, I'm going to try and minimize killing them anyway. And then I can always come back and hunt here. Oh, no, 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 not the golden gecko. You stupid gecko. Oh, that's awesome! Firewood. There we go. The hooch is distilling nicely. 100 experience points for refueling that still. Excellent. Here's some hooch. I won't steal it from him. Maybe we'll take one bottle for our... No. No. I want to get paid. I don't want to cause trouble. I don't want to be a slave like Sulik. Alright, run. Perfect. Alright. Ooh, there's something back there. There you are. Well, Whiskey Bob. Well, thanks for refueling my still for me. Here's your 50. Got any questions I can answer you? Yeah, tell me what's going on. Oh. Tell me about these Brahmin mutilations. They say that critters look like giant man-shaped bugs in the shell and everything are mutilating Brahmin at night. And all they find are torn open, horribly hacked up Brahmin corpses. That sounds horrible. A few people have seen the bugmen. The one who's got the best look was Tor. What he saw scared him half out of his wits, and the poor lad is a bit shy in that department already. Alright, I think we already sorted that out. Tell me about these walking spirits. There's a canyon just to the west of town. They had a bright light in it a few months back. Ever since, every now and then, there's been a horrible squealing sound that comes from the canyon. Brahmin that wander in don't come back. Everyone's afraid to go near. Yeah, if only you guys had a good shaman. Tell me about these gigantic rats. Well, out back of Trapper Town, just to the west of downtown, there's a back section that's overrun by rats. The further back you go, the bigger they get. Some say that there's one huge, great rat spirit that's leading them all. Some say the trappers won't stay there anymore. Some say it's too dangerous. Hmm. Alright. Tell us about this den. Not a den, the den. You'll not find a greater hive of scum and villainy. Nowhere. Now, where did I hear that? In any case, it's a rough sort of place. I hate it when it does this. Rough sort of place. A few days' travel south of Klamath. Anything that can be had there for a price, even slaves. But you have to be very careful there. Lots of short tempers attached to dangerous weapons. Don't think they have much to do with us, though. We're too poor here. Know how to handle myself. Tell me more about these missing people. A trader named Vic, who specializes in pre-war stuff and one of our best trappers. Tell me about the trader that some call Vic. Well, Vic was quite a fellow. He didn't like to work too much, so he would specialize in expensive pre-war things and then go sell them to the den, or even hawk them to stupid tribals as religious artifacts. What? Oops, no offense. Anyway, I hadn't seen him for a while. Last I heard, he went south to sell some stuff, maybe to the den. Oh. So that's where Vic is. What about this missing trapper? The real person to tell you about the missing trapper would be Mrs. Buckner. She and Smiley were pretty close. Yeah. Alright, tell me something else. Have you heard of a G.E.C.K? A Garden of Eden creation kit? Why, I think I saw one of those listed on a page of old catalog I was looking through while I was sitting down out back, but I don't know much about it than that. Really, I like to see that catalog. I kind of use that page to take care of some business, if you know what I mean. My goodness. That's enough disappointment for now. Bye! I wonder if I can then also tell him where is, where... Okay, hold up. So I think we're going to deal with the rats first. He said to the east, right? I want to know what's... Am I bothering you? Yes, you are. You're a nice tribal, not like the other ones. Thanks, kid. Really appreciate that. Hello? Is this someone's house? Huh. Oh, these are the two guys. Hi there, you're here to barter for some of our world-famous Dutton's dry meat? Dry meat? That sounds interesting. Tell me more about that. Well, our dry meat is an incredible blend of 11 herbs and spices. Herbs, whatever. Let me tell you, it's finger-licking good. Animals love it, too. They'll chase you from all over to get some. Must be that rotting smell. Really? That's fascinating. Tell me more. There's nothing more else like it anywhere. It's unique. Most people aren't happy about that. It's barter. Cat's Paw Magazine. Lol. That's what Axion was referring to. A ton of dry meat. Some healing items. I wonder if they want their claws back. They don't. Oh, here's more evidence. We found this where we found the claw. Tolu was them. Do you want to buy it back? Nah, I'm good. Actually, I do need 350. Alright, that's all I need to know now. Goodbye. I don't know where Torg is. I have some questions for you. Have you heard about a G.E.C.K? If you're looking for what? Close to ever get to the Garden of Eden is in lovely Jenny's arms over at Ma's bathhouse. Yuck, yuck, yuck. Oh, you crazy kid, you. Let me ask you about something else. Have you heard about the Brahma mutilations around here? Wink, wink. Well, I hear that there's some, yuck, yuck, bugmen cutting up Brahmin to the east of us, but I won't believe everything you hear here, yuck, yuck, yuck. Alright, well, do you have anything to barter? Oh, interesting, Sal. Ooh, brass knuckles. How much? That could be really useful. 149. Nah, I'd rather have a Sulik first and foremost. I'd like to have one Sulik, please. Uh-oh. My chat disconnected. Come back, chat. I love you. Quick, no one say anything. Not yet. Alright, let's keep exploring out around here, though. First and foremost. There we go. You now may resume talking. Aha, a book. A cat's paw magazine. Sweet. Free cat's paw. Nope. I can see you. I can see you now, Axion. You can't fool me. You can't fool me. There's a lever in here. Ooh. What is all this about? I know. You're busted. Whoa, what the heck is this? A dead pig rat, remains of a dog, dead Brahmin, a sledgehammer. Whose place is this? I'm not taking this stuff yet. Not until I know what the heck is going on. Brahmin bones. A locker. Oh, this is their drying meat shack. Oh, that's disgusting. I guess I could sell a bunch of this meat, but why would I want to? You know what? Since I'm pretty sure that these guys were killing those poor... Okay, I can't remember what his name is. Gruntman? Tor? They're taking his stuff. I'm totally taking that sledgehammer and selling it. Consarn it. But I can still carry it with me because I have ridiculous total weight capacity. I'm not used to that compared to the last game. I'm 100% not used to that. Alright, well, let's help out Trapper Town. You know what? We're going to give it a brand new save in case I regret helping Trapper Town. Have I seen any bugs? Whoa! Never mind, this is the canyon thing. A robot. It sustained a great deal of damage. Its surface is covered with dense scratches, mud, and broken wires. Ooh, hello? Robot? Oh no! Kick the robot! Ooh, 71%. Kick the robot! There you go. Number 5 is alive. Oh my god, he's a stabbing robot! Wounded and has crippled limbs. I hope kicking will do it. I'm gonna die. Alright, we're gonna pretend I don't want to die, so run! Run. Okay. Okay, alright. No, we're gonna play this properly. Okay. Maybe. Even though I'm not good at... Okay, negative 12, that's not happening. But maybe I do need to be able to... Seven hit points. God damn it. Die! Bravely ran away. I'm gonna use up all my healing powder. How much more do I have left? Oh, I don't know. I'd have to check my inventory. I guess we'll find out when it happens. Alright, come on, asshole. Man versus robot sphere. No, 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 no. I wanted to look at him. He's almost dead. All right. I probably will still be streaming after you're done eating. Also, I'm dead.
Not even the cat.
You're right. I do think. You're right, Axion. I do think I need to keep moving. I think you're right. When you're right, you're right. And I'm still exploring this area because I'm insane. All right. It's a robot. Because I totally want to see what's going on here. This looks interesting. You're right, Axion. If I just do one thrust and then move back, then I'm fine. Because it doesn't have the movement for it. Oh, Axion, you're so smart. Axion is smartest. Oh, he's singing the Daisy song. We'll move one more just in case. There we go. Still severely wounded, wow. There we go. Duck. Was it the five rules of duck, dodge, I can't remember. It's dead. And I leveled up. Hey, Rube. Yeah, everything's. I'm all organized for the holidays. I'm doing fantastic. I hope you're doing great, Rube. I'm leveling up for the holidays. Alright. Bonus hand-to-hand damage. Interesting. I still want to be a big guns type of guy, though. So, I might not focus on the hand-to-hand stuff. Oh my god. Kama Sutra Master. Oh my god. Experience in unarmed combat has given you the edge when it comes to damage. For each level, faster healing. I might take here and now. I get another one more experience level, which is actually not horrible. Presence. You command attention just by walking in a room. The initial reaction of another person improves by 10% for each level of this. That'd be interesting for my character, too, because I'm a little Fabio-esque. Quick pocket. Smooth talker would make sense, too. You have learned to increase your dialogue options without understanding what you're talking about. That actually sounds almost exactly how I described my guy. I had one hand job and now I'm a Kama Sutra master. Stonewall, strong back, swift learner, thief. Man, a lot of these are good. I'm tempted between smooth talker. Oh my god, Kama Sutra master. No, I need to have more humping experience before that happens. Presence would be really interesting too. Smooth talker or presence? I think I'm gonna take presence. That makes more sense. Perfect. Now, we're gonna up outdoorsman by one. We're gonna up big guns by a chunk. Then let's see here. I want to up my... You know what? Let's even up a few of these skills. So I don't feel... No, that's just a big waste of points. Honestly. Now let's focus on... the skills that I have. Yeah. Perfect. You guys think I'm qualified for the perk? Well, I'm glad you do. I'll get it next time. How's that sound? Next time we get a little bit more loving. Okay. Alright, let's see what the heck is going on over here. And what are my hit points like? 33 out of 46, okay. A crashed vertebrate. I wish it gave me some sort of description. The remains of a person in some strange kind of armor. What is this? A yellow key card. That's strange. Oh, there's another corpse here, too. A dead person. He was roasted alive. So I have a yellow key card. Well, that's interesting. I'll give it that. Okay. So the trappers must be down here. What's your name?
None of your business.
Business, none of ya. There we go, this is Trapper Town. Buckner House is always giving you a good price. Well, that's good. Trapper, a backwoodsman, and another trapper. And one of the kids. You know what? We're going to give this a niner save. Rats everywhere! You reckon you're one of us now? Always stirring up hell. Hell trouble. Watch me, watch me. Where's your home? Shut up, kid. Are you going to stay here? Do you like me? Where'd you get that? By the great rat spirit, what's next? I don't know. You reckon you're one of us now? You should go south. Maybe I will, man. Maybe I will. How do I get up here? Aha. Oh, wait. There's stairs literally right here. Oh, guns. Hi there, friend. Nice of you to visit us all here. My name's Slim Pickett. I talk for Trapper Town. Hi there, Slim. My name's Ran. Why do you call this Trapper Town? Well, this here part of town is where we all of us trappers live when we're not out trapping geckos. Only problem about the free digs are the rats at the north side. But we have most of the entrances to that part of the mall barricaded. Pretty good. Tell me about trapping geckos. You're interested in trapping, huh? Looks you up and down. Well, you look like you could handle yourself. Geckos come in two types, regular or golden. The regular ones are easy to trap and hunt, but the golden ones are worth more money. Tell me about the golden geckos. The golden geckos are sneaky and twice as vicious as the regular ones. Plus, once they bite you, they hold on and gnaw through to the bone. That's not even counting their poison, but their hides look real nice, and so they're worth a lot more. Tell me more. One good trapper, the name is Smiley, went north looking for wherever they came from. He was convinced that they all came from one place. Thing is, no one's heard from him for a couple months now. What do you think happened to him? Maybe he found where they came from and got all ate up. But I'll tell you one thing, Mrs. Buckner's heart just about broke when he didn't come back. You see, he was her beau. Yes, I know who she is. Tell me something else. Tell me more about these rats. Well, they taste pretty good if you spit roast them with just a titch of herbs, but most of the time they can be a real nuisance. And they're getting worse. We barricaded the north side of the town, but they're sneaking through anyway. There's one door to the north side right here, but I have it locked. We normally just pan fry them. People have been disappearing. Just them that are slow and sickly for now, because of course they don't stop to cook their food like us. They just gnaw it into a few bloody clumps of hair and rags. At least that's all we find in the morning. I've even heard talk that there's some kind of giant rat god that tells them what to do. Maybe someone should do something about that. Do you have a key to that north section? Oh, really, Axion? That's interesting. You want the key to the north side of the trapper? What do you want that for? Well, I'm going to help you with your rat problem. Well, okay, here's the key. Just don't go stirring up too much trouble back there. Make sure you close the door behind you. Thanks, Slim. I have some other questions. You have a lot of cars here. We have a whole lot full of cards, all ready for their owners to come back from shopping. Thing is, they never did. Not a dang one of them runs, though. Here's a real beauty. There's a real beauty of a Chrysalis Motors Highway, and just east of here, but I haven't figured out how to get it to it yet. Interesting. What do you barter for, my friend? Oh, Stimpaks. And a key. How much could I barter? Ooh, 120. Ooh, whoa, that's expensive. Alright, well, that's worth something, though. Oh, I still have 6 of these. That's good. Well, I want to keep talking to folks. Oh, there's a woman there. Ma'am. Oh, I can't get there. I guess we'll go the way that we can go. You unlock the door. Thank you. Thank... Oh, wait. He said close the door behind us. I wonder if I can lock the door behind us, too. That'd be kind of neat. Oh, I can't get there. Okay. Calm down. There could be some good loot back here, though. I need some more water. Be right back. Alright. Hold up. I think we're gonna have a stupid rat you go squish now moment. Anything interesting back here? Just some boxes. Okay. Oh, hold up a second. What is in here? Some shelves. Some stuff. There is literally no stuff here. This makes me sad. This makes me very sad. That's true. Stupid quadrupedal rodent. You go squish now. Ooh. Rubber boots. Ooh, bullet. That can be worth some money. And more rubber boots. Alright. I'll take it. I'll take that. I still have tons of weight I can carry. Oh, it's lovely having a huge... Oh, hello, rat. Stupid rat! You go squish now. I'm gonna squish you. Rip. Oh my god, that rat bit me really hard. Now it's dead. Yep. That's exactly what happened, Axiom. I'm glad you were able to keep... You could catch Ruber up. Where is... Oh, they're coming through here. That's where they're coming from. Hold up. Wait a second. Okay, no, there's nothing through there. Okay, alright. We're good. I know what I'm doing now. Hello, ratties? I'm gonna be horse's ass and kick you. See that? That's what I did to your friend. You're gonna be next. They call me Rat Attack. Thank you. Squoosh. Adorable death noises. Rocks! That's right, run for your life! There was a hand job. Don't tell Mrs. Room. Oh my god, I missed. But so did the rat. Yeah, almost made him a Kama Sutra master, but I decided not yet. He's a quick learner, but he's not that quick. Oh crap. Oh rats. Why must there always be rats at the beginning of all my Fallout games? Oh my god, crunch. Ooh. Strong peasant. Oh. Oh my goodness. There we go. And now he's gone flying. And there's nothing in him. Oh, but there's a way down. Also, this rat wasn't paying attention, and that was its first mistake. Baka? No, wait, Nani? Not Baka. Baka means idiot. Nani means what? Down we go. I should have gotten something. You enter a series of tunnels beneath Trapper Town. The smell of rat droppings is quite strong. They're pooping everywhere. Hold your nose. Oh, good. I think these are just rocks. Yep. So if you really wanted to throw rocks at people, you can. I'm not going to, though. Nope. A wooden door. Bookcase. Nothing. A desk. A chair. More ammunition. Not useful to me, but I'm glad it's here. Oh, holding down shift. You're the best gift a man could ever have. It's true. Oh, okay, we have to go down this way. Is that where we're going now, game? Oh, God. The rats are coming. Help me. Just kidding, I'm fine. God, how many... No, I need a lot of... I need to kill a whole lot of rats to get the next level up. Ugh. One hit point. Oh my god, I missed. You stupid rat! Thank you. Jeez Louise, the things I have to do. There we go. To get a baton. A crowbar. Ooh. I could use that. There we go. We're gonna just be quick saving it for a while, I think. Oh my god, surprise rat! Oh my god, I'm being rat ambushed. Oh my goodness. Alright. Die, and also... die. Thank you. Uh-oh, I'm running out of healing. I lost the perception too, that's less good. So, while I'm murdering these rats, is there anything you'd like to chat about? I'm trying to think in my brain, my mind brain. Surprise! It's not giving me a percentage. Oh well, I guess I don't need a percentage. I know! Grimmith, the prevalence of rodents in today's society and the dangers that they possess. Well, hold up. Okay, in all seriousness, though, it's kind of related to rats. Isn't there, like, around the world now, not a huge outbreak, but, like, a recent outbreak of, like, the bubonic plague? I thought we got rid of that a long time ago. And by get rid of it, I mean everyone who had it died horrifically. Oh my god, please die. Thank you. Yes, this is quite early game. How can you tell that we have a rat killing quest? Yep. You better believe it. It's like the cat came back. Or would you say the rat came back? I think that'd be a little bit more accurate, Grimmith. Ooh, a knife. Guard it. Oh no, that rat has a knife. A knife has a rat. Squoosh. Free knife. What oh no! Application error. Oh, that was a crash knife. Ugh, now I gotta load it again. Just a second. Alright, I'm assuming the stream can still see this now. Yeah, you can. Well, good thing I load it. I save it as often as I freaking do. Where do I have to go? Okay, I'm just at the base of crash knife. Okay. Let's see if the knife really did crash it. Oh god. And I was hit by 4 hit points. And I missed it. There we go. Okay, it didn't crash this time. It was just a regular stupid knife. I lost 4 hit points for nothing. I'm down to 3 healing thingies. god. There's so much more to explore. I'm like Dora the Explorer, but in a horrible rat-infested place. So, not like her at all. I can't remember. My nieces and nephew. Oh! There's a way down. But we're not ready for that yet. Oh no. We have to be ambushed by 700 rats in the meantime. And lose all of our hit points. There we go. The bubonic plant never went poof completely. It's been hanging out, just never been a big resurgence. CDC tells me that they confirmed 1,006 cases of plague between... Oh, wow. Okay, so... Okay. I guess that explains it. I mean, 1,000... But you know what? 1,006 cases in 112 years, with the world's population being what it is still pretty gosh darn incredibly, incredibly rare. But yeah, it's still... Oh my god, don't crash on me. Why did you give me that weird sound, game? No, whatever. All I want to do is kick some rats. All I want to do is kick some rats. I got a feeling it won't make me fat. I don't know how to rhyme with rat. Even though it's easy, like the cat in the stupid, stupid hat. Okay, stop Inferno. I'm putting an end to myself. It cropped up most recently in Mongolia and China this past month, enough to make the news. That's where I heard it. And didn't they get it from eating, like, a raw animal liver? Pretty sure that's how they got it. If my memory serves me right. That's right, you run away. Alright, free sledgehammer. We gotta get that. Also, there's a rat kicking around here still. Aha! No. Not yet. Ooh, and a skeleton. Oh, crap! The blow knocks me off my feet? I don't think so. I ain't getting my feet knocked off because of some stupid dumbass rat. Oh my god. My one hit point. All your hit points. Now where was that skeleton? There it was. It's free. Sweet. Second crowbar. Whatever, man. This is all money. No. Good. Oh my god. 71% chance. How dare you fail me. 71%. How dare you show your stupid face. 29%. Take. Thank you. You see sledgehammer. Sledgehammer. Well, now I have to just kill the rest of these rats, because it's a mission of mine. I mean, how can I say I'm going to help them out with the rat problem if I don't help them out with the rat problem? Right? The first rule of Tautology Club is the first rule of Tautology Club. Oh, hey, look! A barrel of waste. It was underneath a mall? Why was it underneath the mall? Also, I'm saving this. In case we get Crashland 2 Electric Boogaloo. Pretty sure it was just a wild rabbit. Oh, that makes sense. Rodent, rabbit, rats, you know, fleas. So yeah, the rabbit had, I bet you the plague carrying fleas, and the rest is history. Alright, am I missing anything exciting? I don't think so. I think I've murdered everything that goes on four legs around here. So, let's save it before we go down, in case we regret our decisions and life choices. Also, what time is it? We're doing this at 10 o'clock at night? Alright. Sure. We can rest. We can rest when we're dead. Oh, great, mole ratties. Oh, wait, regular ratty. Okay, good. I might go up. You know what? Actually... You know what? Let's be smart. Let's go up. Let's, first of all, rest up at that boarding house. Do a little bit of trading. Maybe get a few more healing items. Maybe even have an ore. Maybe you have enough to sell to get a Sulik. Oh, Grimmoth. Run. Flee. Let your wonderful locks fly in the air. Go, go, go. Actually, talk with him first. You sure don't look chewed up by those rats yet. But you will if you keep pestering them. Just don't bring Benny back with them. Don't worry, I won't. Just be careful. The deeper you go, the bigger they are. Exactly. That's why I'm running away. Are you from far away? Oh, my God. Oh, if only I could pull... If I had the heart to pull a Grimmoth and just murder all you stupid fucking kids. Just murder all of you. That's all I want to do. Uh-oh. In my head, I just popped up, you know, the all I want to do is have some fun, but substitute have some fun with kill some kids. And I'm like, ooh, don't sing that. That's going to get the FBI on you, or the, I guess I'm in Canada, so the CSIS, the Canadian Secret Intelligence Services, after me. Okay. Reported! Alright, I would like to buy some things. You want a barter? Yes, I would like to trade with you. I would like to trade with you. I will trade one of those. And all of these, because I don't need them. And all of these, because I don't need them. Oh. I don't know why I have these bug claws. Here, just have them. If I really need them back, I'll buy them back. But I don't think I do. I'm going to keep them with me for a little while anyway. Maybe I can wrap up a quest. I probably didn't do things properly for that to happen. Some rope. Ooh, okay. 199. Oh, maybe I'll have enough for a Sulik. 46. Alright. Give me all the coins you can. Give me this rope. You never know when you need some rope. Give me this flare. And then give me both of these. That's pretty close. That's pretty close. Whoa, that's expensive. Okay, hold up. Oh, that's fine then. Whatever. You can take the 11 caps. It doesn't have to be exact. That's the fun thing about bartering. You can say, close enough. 366. Okay, so not only... That's all I need for now. Goodbye. Save game. Save this as Sulik. Alright, let's free him. I have some questions for you. Tell me about Sulik. Paying off his debt. Why is he so upset? Slaver's got a sister. What if someone else paid for him? I want to pay his damages. Well, okay, then if you really want to pay for the damage he caused, I guess all you tribals really do stick together. Yes, I do. You must be crazy. I'm sure... Glad to have that damn trouble away from here. Uh-huh. Well, somehow I think Sulik might actually miss being here, but we'll be back to visit sometime, I'm sure. Right now, though, I do need something.
I don't need anything now. Sulek!
We be here.
Tell me about yourself.
We and I be glad to answer.
We already know about this part. Why do you travel so much? Would you like to come with me? We might be able to find your sister through the course of my travels.
We're there. Grandpa Bones say we might find sis with you.
I hope so. In any case, it'd be nice to travel with you and your grandfather's bone.
Not just Grandpa Bone, all tribe spirits. Grandpa Bone just wiser and stronger than the rest.
Okay.
Let's ease on down.
Whatever, Sulek. Whatever, you crazy ass tribal. Oh my god, you have leather armor.
What you be need?
Alright. Talk about distance. Stay close to me. Let's talk about your deer. Gear. What kind of weapons can you use?
Spear, big hammer, or submachine gun.
We be a handful.
That's it for now. Oh my god. Sulek, come here. I got 500 experience points. Look at that, Sulek. Alright. I can push him. Do we have to do the old steel truck with this guy? Okay, so you have that and that. So why don't you put on your armor?
You got it, friend. We be good with fist, spear.
That's weird. Okay, that's fine. Let's rest. Pack mule acquired. I want to ask you about something. I need a room, please. 25. I don't think I need that room right now. I need to get that 25 money dollars, though. And I can do that by talking to these at... Oh, wait. Where's the stupid twins? What? Ruh-roh. Okay. Now we might be in trouble. Now we might have to sleep outside. We totally are going to have to sleep outside. That's fine. We can sleep outside. Toxic caves. I gained my perception back too. That's good. Okay, character. Done. First aid on myself. Why not? I failed to do any healing. I'm still gonna try. One more time. Ooh, I earned experience for healing one hit point. Hold up a second. I'm gonna save this real quick. Because I could have swore if I... Is it the buttons? Yeah, the numbered buttons. Alright. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's see if that works. Take care, Rube. Oh, it does work. Can I just do this forever? Whatever. Oh, wrong button. Oh, it's like 4 o'clock now? What? Here, rest until healed. Okay. Perfect. Off we go, Sulek. Trapper Town.
All right. Take care, Axion. God, kids, go away. Oh, Sulek. All right. All right, let's see how things go with our friend Sulek here. Well, that's interesting. This ladder goes up another direction. Oh, also, I should totally light this flare once I come back from upstairs. Upstairs. Yeah, you know, whatever's up here, I guess. Technically, it's up the stairs, more like up ladder, but hey, you know, who's counting? It's a cave wall. Is it? I guess it is. Okay, so be it. Wait, what the heck is this thing? Oh, just a bunch of boxes. Oh, shit. This is a whole other level. Well, let's finish this level first. Yeah. Oh, hey, a pistol. And I wonder what that possibly could be. A large white mole rat. It's the king rat. It's the rat king. Okay. We're gonna do something. We're gonna... There we go. Oh, shit. Get him, Sulek. Okay. I don't know why the game did that, but whatever. Oh god, this game is freaking out. It's like skipping my turn. It's kind of weird. There we go, now it's not skipping my turn, now it's murdering me. Severely wounded. That king rat. Oh god. So hurt. Help me, Sulik. There we go. There we go. Yay! It's dead. 50 karma, King Ra'at. Okay, I approve. Also, I take this. There's nothing on King Ra'at, but I'm saving the freaking game. Good job, Sulik. He looks dead and has crippled limbs. You don't say. Well, hello, mole rat. Meet my friend, Sulik. Huh. That's kind of weird that it's doing this. I'm gonna save it and reload the game and see what happens here. See what happens here. Where are we? There we are. Alright, we'll see what combat is looking like after this. Okay. Some bones. A rat. Thank you, Sulik. Love you. Sulik, best investment in 350. I was gonna say caps, but 350 monies. Okay, and also this glitch isn't happening anymore, which is great. Which is fan dabby dozy. Oh look, Brock Flower. Or not. This flower is just a big tease. There we go, Xander Root. I just had to get it at the exactly right pixel. That's all. Nothing special. Sorry, come to me, rat. There we go. Welcome back, Small Fry. Yeah, although I did murder the R-O-U-S already. He got M-U-R-D-E-R-D. D-R-E-D, yeah. I spelled that right. That would have been a bear thing if I couldn't. And welcome back, Small Fry. All right. How far away am I from leveling up? Ooh, not very far. Alright, let's see what's up here. Might as well keep exploring while we can. What's the time? Ooh, it's... Should we rest down here? Eh. Let's keep going. Name murdery. Oh God. Yeah, that's right. You better run away. 120 hit points. You know what? This is worth one more of these. Murdery. So how are things going with you, Small Fry? I hope they're going well. I hope the holiday season is a good times for you. I like those big rats. They get squished pretty easily and, you know, 120 hit points, I'm not going to say no to. Oh my god, die. Thank you. Oh, there's one. There's that big bag of meat and XP. That's what I'm going to call my dinner. A big bag of meat and XP. Ooh, there's treasure down there. Hello? Oh, whatever. I'll come back for you later. Oh, no. Here he is. Hello. Yeah, that's right. Oh, that's beautiful. Punch. Kick. Oh, and I murdered him in one go. Oh, sweet. I'm fine. A terribly cooked omelet. Ah, Christmas parties. That sounds fun. That sounds delightful. Alright, what's in here? Ooh! I approve of this. Healing. Hey, look! Actually, hold up. Let's talk with Suluk for a second here.
What you be need?
Can you consult the spirits for us?
Spirits are sometimes hard to understand. They see things you and we can't.
What do they tell you about this place?
Evil spirits aren't killing cattle.
Oh, okay.
What you be need?
That's it for now. Oh, Suluk. Ooh. There's a book or a thing in there. Exciting. Oh, hello. Goodbye. Ah, man, having a high-strength character is awesome. I'm just gonna say that. I just want everyone to know that. Hello, everyone. Having a high-strength character is really fun. We and I be glad to answer. The Burning One. Oh my god, the Burning One. What an amazing username you has. Also, I'm gonna play smart, not dumb. Oh, Opa! The Burning One, thank you so much for following. Flex and dunk on those dweebs. Yep, and soon we will no longer have to be worrying about this. Soon we will level up. All will be well. I will be happy. Oh, hello. Oh, God. Yeah, dunk. Oh, wait. You're not dead yet. Uh-oh. Help me, Suluk. That's not... There we go. About to say, that's not helping, sir. Ah, 75 hit points. I'm pretty sure having a nosebone would have been all the rage in pre-war times, Suluk. Maybe. all I know is that shift highlighting things is the best thing in the world. A tool. It's a tool, everyone. You know what the best... Okay, I'm going to just tell you right now. After playing Fallout 1 and then taking a break and now returning to Fallout 2, I'm going to tell you what the gosh darn best thing is about having high strength. This! 250 total weight capacity compared to like the what? Like 100 or 90 that I had? Oh. I mean, I did... The problem was is I like to carry around some stuff that I thought was very like appropriate for my character. But holy crap, is it nice to just carry stuff. I prefer having a high agility. Oh, high agility is amazing. Yeah, it's the two most... Two of the one of the make two... Two, one, okay, let's try that one more time, Inferno. Two of some of the most important aspects out there, which is high AC and high action points. Oh, hello. That mole rat was tired of listening to me talk, so he's like, okay, that's it, we're fighting now. Uh-oh. Save you, Sulik. Thank you. And a level... Oh my goodness, it must be my birthday. Oh my god, dynamite. Oh my god, a crowbar. Oh my gosh! Let's save it before I level up in case I regret my saving decisions. Alright. Alrighty! Let's see. We're going to pop this up to 60. Pop this up to 60. And where do we want to put my next 5? Probably, I don't know how long it's going to be till I get a big gun. So speech? Or do I want to do unarmed? Bring that up to 80. Is that really going to be all that useful? Maybe, actually. Once again, I don't know when I'm going to be getting a big gun, but 75% is pretty darn good, actually. You know what? Let's speech it. Now, this door appears to be locked, everyone. You might be asking yourself, Inferno, why are you quicksaving this? The answer is... Run, Sulik! Hide behind these barrels with me. Yeah, Fallout 2 really was about quality of life improvements. You're absolutely right. Also, I love the little snowflake next to your name, Burning One. And my enjoyment for your username might be slightly biased. And now we play the waiting game. Alright, waiting game's over. Now, it might have been smart of me to save that dynamite to get into the back of Vic's stuff, but hey, you know what? Some boxes. It's really just for a ladder up, it looks like. That's fine. Ooh. Good waiting game, everyone. Oh god, Grimmeth. If I may just say for a moment, one of my favorite replies you ever had to any of my tweets was, and I do remember this clearly, I saw, what was it, Dead Island in my, I got it years ago, and then I, what? No, okay, thanks, Sulik. And I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna install, I'm gonna replay it. And then I played it for like 2 hours, and I'm like, this game sucks, and I uninstall it. That was pretty much my tweet. Forgot how bad this game was. Installed it, played it, forgot how bad it was, uninstalled it, and Grimmeth is just like, good talk. Good talk, everyone. It made me laugh. I can't go into the Nuka-Cola machine? Oh, yeah! Planescape Torment. Well, good old Planescape Torment. Oh, I think this is the... Oh, I see. This is the car you can get later on once you have a... That's true. It was a self-contained story. You find a fuel injection system in the back seat. 200 experience points. So I exchanged... Okay. So I have a fuel injection system. Some car owners install this regulator, which doubles your car's mileage between charges, but most drivers don't care how much juice their car's consumed after all. Power's cheap. Plentiful, so why worry? Ah. I forgot, you don't actually get this car, but you get a carburetor for this car. And I didn't find anything else. Still, 100% worth it. Is there anything to look or read or take? Ooh, a Nuka-Cola. A little bit of that sweet, sweet Nuka-Cola. And now we get to play the backtracking game. Wait, hold up. I think there's a... Aha! Treasure? I don't think there's any treasure here. I was wrong! There's booze and Nuka-Cola. That's a kind of treasure. Else here, maybe? Presents for Inferno? No presents for Inferno. Change in between the cushions? No change. Oh well. Can I open this? That's true. Alright. Quick save in case we lose our way or we fall in a crack and die or something. You can't do that in this game, but I'm freaking paranoid. I think I'm paranoid. Alright. Run, run, run. One last look around while I press shift. Okay. And this ladder... Pretty sure it's that ladder. Yes. Oh, surprise rat. Whoa. He got me while I was in mid-jog. Uh-oh, that's probably why I couldn't kick very well. And then, now he's dead. Good job, Sulik. Oh, Sulik. Did you know you can use money on the Nuka-Cola machines? I did not know. I'm not going to. Because I don't want to backtrack now. But for all the future ones, I'll check it out. That's actually really neat. I hadn't... You see? Things that I learn. High kicking a rat. I know. So now, hopefully... I remember when I played this years ago. There's a way to learn how to skin... geckos. And I think maybe it's from this guy after this quest is done. I think either that or Smiley. I hope it's this guy, though. I wonder what happened to the rats. You should took the fight out of them. You're a regular Pied Piper, aren't you? You're amazing. Yeah, thank you. Maybe was it this guy? No, he's just a dude. Good fortune to you. I don't want your good fortune. I want to learn. Rat tastes better than most people. Hungry? Yeah, I know how to do it. Like this little mini menu thing. That, and you go into your inventory and do that. Yeah. Yeah, I know. Oh, shit. I didn't even look over here. Maybe there's a guy in here that will tell me how to... No. Damn it. Maybe it is going after Smiley. Yeah, thanks, kid. Maybe this Smiley. He is a trapper after all. We're going to save the game. See if there's anything else I can buy. It is smiley? Okay, thank you. Thank you. Oh, hey, you have money again. Oh, I forgot that this happens in this game. That's great. Alright. I don't need this beer. I'm going to keep all but one Nuka-Cola, because I want to drink a Nuka-Cola, and I want to eat a thingy of meat and see what it does. Combat knife. Do I really need the combat knife? No. Bullets, I don't need. This gun I don't need. I am mostly doing hand-to-hand combat, though, clearly. Now, don't you have, like... No, the other guy has... Okay, hold up. Hold up. Hold up, man, I'm not ready. I haven't made my decision yet. Don't need anything right now. Bye. Alright. Ah, there we go. There's these nerds. They have what I want. Yes, they do. I like to barter. Because you should have... Oh, no. I thought one of you guys had... Iron. Aha. That's what I want. Oh, really? Interesting. Good stuff. You know, this healing stuff probably wouldn't hurt it either. I'll keep these tools just in case. I'm gonna keep these for a reason. You'll see why. I don't need this meat. I don't think I need this either. I think I'm gonna just trade that to them. That's fine. The gun. No. You guys can have the beer. You guys probably like the bubbly. There we go. Here. Is there anything? I'm going to keep this Cat's Paw magazine because I think it's hilarious. I mean, how else are we going to learn our Karma Sutra skill? Eh, whatever. Have two. Well, you're both so damn stupid and ugly. Besides, I don't give a flying fuck what you're denting. I'm yelling at goodbye, asshole. Yeah, sorry. Okay, I don't need anything. Bye. Oh my god, kid. Alright. I mean, I'll sell this before it burns out, because I think that's hilarious, actually. Quick. I need something. I like to buy some things. I like to trade with you. Still get 60. How much will you sell? 71. Not bad. Actually, I might go for that. We'll see. Selling that. Selling that. Selling that. Perfect. 555. Well, this is still too much for me. Way too much. That's a skin some geckos and do some shit type of thing. So 220. Okay. What else is useful to me? This is useful to me. Okay. This is useful to me. Ooh, that's also way too expensive. This is useful to me. 455. $506, okay, interesting. I can always just use that as... Well... Wouldn't it make more sense in front of just to take something off? There we go, $475 for $455. It's not horrendous. And in the meantime, maybe... Get something cheap like a Nuka-Cola? There we go. That'll do it. That'll do it. That'll do it just fine. Yep. My offer's not good enough. Huh? Did you glitch out because I'm giving you something that's... Hold up. Where are your caps, lady? Bet you that's it. Let's try this. Aha! She's not stupid! I can't sell something that's lit up. That's funny. That also makes a lot of sense. Okay, what do we got here? 80, 74. Oh, I was off by 20. I'm actually kind of impressed. She's not that dumb. 80. You have 40 coins left. Nah. Alright, it's 10:41. We're gonna save the game. We're gonna take a room. Oh, that's locked. Fair enough. Alright, let's see here. You. Let me ask you something. I'd like a room, please. Here's a 25. Thanks so much. Rest until morning. Sulek, move. The spirits be moving you. Yeah, you're damn straight they are. Okay. Have we done everything here? Let's see here. Moo-moos, booze, we did that. Bath, we did that. Lizard hides, not yet. Old stuff here. What was that? Genuine antiques. Oh, yeah, that was Vic the Traitor. And missing person Smiley. Okay. Let's go save Smiley, everyone. Okay. And before we depart, we're doing that. Toxic Caves. Hello. See you in hell, Gecko. This is quite good. All right. Now, I wonder if he'll still be chasing after me. Oh no, he's going after Shulik. Like how, Shulik? Oh shit, the golden gecko. It's gone flying. Oh, and it's dead. Oh, shit. Oh. Hello, Nicadian. That's interesting. That's an interesting thing that Twitch does. Oh, no. That's coming for me. Shulik. You're so murdery. Oh, shit. I forgot about this. That thing isn't dead yet? There we go. He is severely wounded. Shulik, come here. I have something for you. One more for Shulik. Okay. Okay, Sulik, stay here.
This look like a good place to sit back for a bit.
Yeah, you sit back for a bit. Because I have bootsies I want to use. Unless I do it this way? Does it automatically work? I think it automatically works for me. It does. Ooh! That's really nice. That's really nice. Okay. Save game. Alright, Sulik. I have something for you. Okay, it's 3. Alright, we're gonna give you 4 of this. What? Oh, God. Okay, he didn't like that. Oh, shit. Okay, good. Oh, thank goodness. Oh, thank goodness for my stupid saving insanity. Wait, how many give you now? Is it this?
What you be?
Oh, let me guess. Barter? Hopefully it's always 0. Otherwise, I'm going to be sad face. Oh, no, it's not always 0. Hmm. Actually,
what you be need?
Spirits be willing to look at this place.
Can't kill in cattle. What you be need?
Let's go.
What you be need?
Hey yourself. That's it for now. I think you're gonna follow me now, hopefully. Yeah, you are. Okay, good. It is a pain in the ass at the start of the game, you're right. Why won't you die? Thank you. All right. That's just a dead rat. Interesting. Interesting. Oh my god. He's everywhere. Holy golden geckos, Batman. Ah, there's our boy. What's the path of least resistance? The high road. Oh, actually, the low road. Yeah, actually. No, maybe the high road. One, two, no, never mind, three, and this one is just, like, what, one? Okay, I can do that. The only question is, well, let's deal with him first. Let's give him a little punch. Now my turn. Okay, he's going for me. That's not very nice. Let's step back a couple. Ouchie. There we go. Now to heal myself. Alright, from here on out, Sulek, like, you can, like, fight them. Alright. So, one. Well, let's go for the high road. Let's go for that high road, shall we? And I'll get to Scotland before ye. I bet you I could probably try to sneak past these guys, but I'm not gonna bother. Save me, Sulek. You tank the damage for once. Oh, it's coming for me still. Oh, he's still coming for me. A little shit. Alright, if you want to keep coming for me, I'll just keep running back and forth like this, and Sulek will keep smacking you in the face. Now you're dead. Shows you how smart you are. Oh, if only there was a quick save key. Oh shit, there's two up here too? Well, poop. Oh well. We'll just try to kite one at a time. There we go. That's right. Whatever, man. This works. Don't judge me. There is a quick save. F6, you believe? Oh my god. We're gonna try that after this fight. Get him, Sulik. Oh my god, you keep missing. I need to play some freaking yakety sacks behind this. There we go. How do you look? Severely wounded. Good. Yeah, man, can you feel the rhythm? Feel the rhythm! Feel. Oh god, I got stabbed. There we go, die. Alright, let's try. Let's find out if F6 does it. Oh, pick a quick save slot. That one. Oh my god. Oh my god, small fry. You're amazing. I think everyone in this stream is very grateful now. I know I am. Over here, Gecko. Over here. Attack me. There we go. There we go. That's a good Gecko. No, don't kill Sulik. Agreed. Oh, come on. There's one dead guy.
What you be need?
You should probably heal yourself now.
That be a good thing.
Oh, why am I? Oh my god, now it's a force of habit. Oh, I'm gonna still keep up a backup save. Don't you worry. I know how that works. Alright, speaking of, I wanna see if Sulik is gonna get hurt crossing this or not. Oh, he is. Okay, hold up. Okay, so you stay here, Sulik.
Like a good.
You see a filthy trapper with torn, bloodstained clothing. He appears to be favoring one leg shortly. Slightly. Hello there, stranger. People call me Smiley. I'm sure glad to see you. I thought I was going to die here for certain. I'm hurt too bad to get past these damn lizards on my own. Thank you, small fry. What are you doing here? I always caught more golden geckos north and west of Klamath than anywhere else, so I figured all the golden geckos live someplace out here. Well, yeah, looks like you were right. Looks as though I was a little too right. I got in here okay, but then one of those damn geckos got behind me and damn near took my leg off. Oh my god. Oh my god, Tiny Wrath has little shades now. I just barely made it out of here. I wonder why they didn't finish you off. Well, I guess they didn't like to crawl through the goo too much, but I can't say I blame them. Sure burns if it gets on your skin, but that doesn't seem to stop him from looking up the darn stuff like it was Buckner's best. Interesting. Enough gum flapping. Now let's get out of here. I figure that if I can join you, we should both be able to make it out of here. Okay, I sure could use the help. Okay, you can join me. I'll make sure you get out of here and back to Klamath. I think that Arden is going to be glad to see you again. And now, we're going to give it a hard save. Because we don't want to do all that again in case we F up. What is this, a computer? Looks like it's barely functional. I'm gonna try science the computer. You fail to learn anything, okay? A generator. Generator probably powers the elevator. Oh yes, what's in here? Ooh. Well, we'll worry about this a little bit later. What the heck is that? A glowing eggshell. Now, let's see if Smiley can get across here without getting hurt. He can. Good. He cannot. Whatever.
What you be need?
Let's go.
What you be need?
That's it for now. For sure. Cheese it. It's the Gecko Cops. No, goddamn it, Smiley. He melts down and everyone cries, including me. Alright. Alright, Smiletastic, off we go. Hey, thanks for saving my ass. I better hightail it back to Klamath. See you there. See you there! Alright. That's more than fine. Downtown. Downtown. Radiation. Ow. 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 So much ows. We'll get our reward first, and then we'll save it. Oh, look who's happy to have Smiley back. You're the one who found my Smiley. Thank you so much. Smiley got lucky this time. You just tell him to be a bit more careful. Well, I just don't know whatever I can do to thank you. Well, money is always a nice way of saying thanks. I don't have much, but here's 100. I wish it could be more, but with all that Brahmin we lost, that's all we can afford. That's okay. Thanks, Miss Buckner. Bye. Okay, teach me how to skin geckos. Teach me how to boogie. I sure owe you for saving my hide. The least I can do is to teach you something in return. Teach? Since those geckos nearly had my hide, let me teach you how to get theirs. Here's how you skin them. Smiley demonstrates. And when you kill them, you can get their hides and sell them. Okay. Thanks, I'm sure that'll come in handy. Tell me something else, though. Well, I have a few questions about hunking them. How do I hunk? I am a hunk. How do I make sure they're hunks? Do I give them long flowing hair? I think maybe you can teach me something about geckos. I don't think I could help you out with that. All right. I want to know all you can teach me about geckos. There's more than you need to know than you ever need. Teach me, oh great trapper. Yes. Well, you see, it's like this. Golden geckos and regular geckos are basically the same critter, except that the golden one's got a big second helping of sheer cussedness. Cussedness. Time passes as you learn the lore of the geckos. That was great. I think I know a lot more about geckos now. Does that get me anything? Oh, gecko skinning. Oh. Karma. I murdered so many geckos. Okay. Well, is Mrs. Buckner happy to see you back? Widow Buckner is so darn happy to have me back that she may be Mrs. Smiley before too long. She was even talking about giving you a little something to find your hair, for finding my hairy butt and returning it to her. Alright, that's barter. Oh my god. Oh my god, Nicadian. You're deprived! Deprived, I tells you. Alright. Goodbye. Alright, we're gonna trade a little bit with you. I'm back because I need something. I want to buy some things. Yes, I'd like to trade with you, ma'am. I want to see if you still have money. You do have 150 money. Good. I want to get rid of this because I really don't care for it. And I want to... That is literally all I want. So just give me 80 monies. I'm happy. Okay. That's all I need now. Goodbye. Okay. Ayanna, we don't need to know your butt is hairy, Smiley. TMI, Smiley. TMI. Okay. And I'm going to give it one more hard save because, everyone, I think I'm going to wrap her up. Yes, I am. I think it's... I might resume this later on tonight. We'll see. I'm going to take a break for dinner. Anyway, but I'll try to stream tomorrow. I might be a little bit busy. Oh god, who's winking at me? No, he's not missing anymore, you stupid drunk. Anyway, now we know how that we skin geckos. We'll probably skin some stuff, get nice and prepared. And yeah, bye, Kermit. And go from there. But thanks everyone for watching, and we will catch you again next time. Oh, thanks, Small Fry. Okay, bye.